fell in the water or fell through ice. Obviously, with the winter we've had so far, there's no ice today. So if someone did fall through the ice or someone just fell out of a boat, fell out of the canoe, anything like that, they're on the surface. They're in need of help. Just something that we could demonstrate to how we would go out and rescue somebody. The first thing, we're gonna have a guy go in the water. The first thing we're gonna do is just a throw bag. It's called a throw bag rescue. We're gonna try to throw a rope out to you to grab onto, and we'll pull you back in the shore. Secondly, if it is really cold out or you fell through the ice and you couldn't hang on to the rope, then we'd send somebody out there to come and rescue you. So I'm gonna have a guy get in the water here, and then we're going to just do what's called a throw bag rescue.
Okay, watch him.
Oh my god.
Now what he learned is called an ice commander suit.
Keep
them dry and keep them warm. Insulation built into it. We cut a hole in the ice and we do training. Just put on that suit, and it's perfectly warm inside, and they're not getting hot or anything like that. But basically, you don't want to let it get splashed. Yes, that's cool. It has its own inherent buoyancy in it.
Why is that guy just standing in the water?
Alright, just to throw a rope out, so this will be our first thing that we will try to do for you. No one that needs help, before we get in the water, we're going to try to get you out of the water without us entering the water.
Okay.
Throw the rope out to you, grab onto it, and pull it in. The limitations with this, that's the type of rescue of rope is 75 feet long. If you're farther out than 75 feet out, we can throw a rope to you. So our second option would be to go out and rescue you. So we have a rescuer that's tied off. He's going to go out to rescue the victim. So we can go up to 200 feet anywhere over there. We also carry inflatable boats on our bikes. So if you can go farther than 200 feet out, you can inflate. Alright, so the second rescue is going to go out to rescue the victim. While he's going out there, he's going to talk to the victim, try to calm him down. Someone that didn't fall through ice or just fall in the water in general, they would be a little panicked. So you want to try to calm him down as best you can. Little simple water safety thing, if you are on a boat or anything like that, you should be wearing a life vest. Fall in the water, even if it's icy water and you have a life vest on, you can last up to a couple hours in the water around this area. I'm not talking about extreme, this is the last one. The if you go through this water here, you can last for a couple hours just with a life vest on. When he gets out to him, he's going to wrap the rope around him. He's going to hang on to the victim. He taps the top of his head. That's the signal for them to start pulling him in. They start pulling him in. And you have a little fun with the new guy when he's out there doing it.
Right, you're just sitting there filming. Keep all your poles on and you keep your body to the side.
Anybody have any questions?
It's just a bag of rope that has a little bit of a flotation device on the end of it. But we're trying to throw it out to there, so out past the victim, so you grab onto the rope and then they pull you up the rope.
Thank you.